So this video is in tandem with other video I made on daily affirmations. And the thing is, when you have been abused, traumatized, neglected, your ability to make decisions, to have boundaries, to stand up for yourself has been categorically and systematically destroyed, whether by default or design. That is a question for another day, another time. But having said that, there are certain things we need to get into, like our how we perceive the world, how we feel about the nature of reality, the world we live in, what is our perception of how institutions work, the government works, relationships work, and to identify boundaries. So to identify basically spiritual boundaries, mental boundaries, emotional boundaries, and realize when someone is crossing them, if someone is disrespecting you back, and you've told them and they're not listening to you, you can leave the conversation, you can stop talking to them. There are many options you can use. But it's important to know these boundaries in advance. So when you feel guilty, when someone is trying to make you feel guilty, which means that you're a bad person unless you listen to me, then that is a sign of coercion. Coercion is not just by holding a gun to your head. It is also about realizing that there are a lot of different ways to do that, whether by shaming you, like what kind of a person are you, or by making you feel like you have to do this, you need to do this when you don't really have to. So all these things go together to make us feel responsible for things we're not, and to convince us to do things we don't particularly want to. So realizing where these start and where this ends is very important. So journaling about all these things is important, whether about childhood traumas, like, well, how is it affecting you today? Why do you choose to go back or be with people who have repeatedly abused you, who have shown you that they don't respect you for who you are, what you stand for, and all those things? So questioning, like, how you perceive life and death, how you perceive aging, how you perceive physical beauty. Maybe we're all, like, attracted to physically beautiful people, but realizing that that is because it confers social status and social recognition onto us is important. Realizing all these things will help us develop a more well-rounded philosophy on things. So some other questions we can ask ourselves is, how am I trying to recreate love approval that is denied to me? What makes me addicted to highs and lows? What sort of chaos have I been attracting into my life? And how can I design ways to avoid that in the future? What attracts me to people in general as friends? What am I looking for in friendship? What are the limits of friendship itself? Do I believe that friendship can surpass all limits? We may not have realistic standards of love, of friendship, of all these things when we are, we've had this traumatic past. So realizing all of that is super important. So realizing whether, do I want to pursue people who repeatedly ignore, dismiss my discomfort? Because if someone doesn't care about you being uncomfortable on a regular basis, that is a problem, because they don't really care about you, your emotions, who you are, what you stand for, and perhaps, probably you don't really want those people around, but that's up for you to decide. What makes someone worthy or substantial in your books? What sort of people do you want to find? What sort of person do you think you are, like, intellectually speaking? What sort of energy level do you like in other people or as you find in yourself? How can you pick those levels up when you're feeling down? All these questions are really important to ask ourselves to become well-grounded in this journey. How can you make better decisions? what are your problem solving skills. You can also research other problem solving skills. So you figure out how you can react differently in different situations. So for instance, if you're going into a situation which you anticipate will be difficult, like you're going for dinner and perhaps your ex is going to be there, or it's a professional dinner and you're feeling anxious, you're feeling scared, then you can sort of go over likely scenarios that are that will arise and think of ways you can deal with them in advance, so when you go into the situation you're more well prepared, especially if you find it difficult to deal with anxiety, social situations. Depending on what you particularly want to work on, you can identify those things and start working on them. What about the situation makes me uneasy? What are the chances of success here? Make fewer decisions, smaller ones, and carefully examine them if you have difficulty making decisions. Try practicing your problem-solving skills more and more. Try journaling about yourself, your identity, your beliefs, what you believe is right or fair in different situations, because what a lot of people, even if you haven't been through all of this, you sort of need to reflect and pause, and that's kind of what we've lost in our day-to-day lives, the ability and the desire to reflect on these things. So reflecting on them will certainly increase our chances of success in different situations and build our neural pathways to make better decisions for the future. So what do I like, dislike? This could be about general things, your taste in music, in art, in whatever you're interested in. But also, what do I like about myself? What do I dislike? What do I want to work on? What can I sort of tolerate? So there may be certain things that we feel really anxious about, but perhaps they're not such a big deal for us personally. But it's because other people have made it seem to us that that is super important. Because socially that may be really important, but maybe it's not important to you. So realizing those areas where social values do not go in accordance with your personal values is important. So you don't just go with the flow and live an inauthentic life without even considering what your life could be. So, what are the potential consequences of going ahead or not going ahead with a particular course of action as per your feasibility report? So use intuition and logic. So, what do you think is justice? What do you think is honesty? How do you think honesty works? Do you think lying by omission is lying? When is that okay? Maybe in worse situations, it's everyone has a filter. Everyone cannot just open up and show everything to everyone. So complete honesty all the time is, again, like pretending to be God. It's not really real, because all of us sort of have filters that we create to protect ourselves in this world, in this reality, in people. So realizing the dynamics of the world we live in is really important to grow as a human being, and how we perceive that versus what we have been told. How do your cultural beliefs and things you've been taught align with who you are, and how do they not do that? So identifying all these questions will help us grow in the future. Talking about important topics like money, love, sex, health, how do you think you should be eating, how do you think you should be exercising, and then identifying easy ways to go about that initially with smaller steps, and then building up that momentum for the future is really important. So when you feel weird in a particular situation, analyzing that, like, is this proportionate? Is this because oftentimes our feelings are good indicators, but sometimes they may be disproportionate. So going back and reflecting on those things really helps us grow and develop ourself, which has perhaps been compromised along the way. So we may need to disengage and de-escalate if someone is trying to pick a fight with us. Instead of getting aggressive or just being passive, finding that middle balance path where we can sort of assert ourselves, and we can just be like, no, I don't want to do that. Smile, just repeat it once and then walk away. That person is trying to insult you or trying to get you worked up. There may be different ways to respond to it. You may choose to sort of like give them the message to shut up in different words, not that. There are so many ways to deal with situations, and the more you start analyzing them, even retroactively, after the situation has occurred, you will be able to have better choices, better decisions in the future. So, what do you think being good is? What do you think being evil is? What do you think you mean? What do you think, what is your idea of like the best day with yourself or with someone else? What are the activities you would like to happen in your day? So realizing all the different facets of ourselves. So what do you value most? Some people value personal growth. Some people value like particular things. So think about what those things are and how those things can affect you and how you can work towards them so you live in accordance with that. So if you love nature, you can find a place where you can be close to this. So somewhere in your neighborhood, wherever you want to go, maybe out in the mountains, in the woods, by a lake, whatever. Realizing these things will help you sort of get there, slowly, gradually build that up. So, what do you think is, you know, like, are you sort of applying your standards to other people? Do you feel like sometimes they apply their standards and you just conform to them? When do you do this? When are you more likely to do this? When do you not want to do that? If you don't like something about someone, how can you say this? So you can sort of prepare lines like a script, like, hey man, this happened already. And it made me feel bad. So, a lot of the times we may feel scared of being made fun of, ignored, and that person may not listen to us, but realize if that person is consistently not listening to us and doing those things, then we don't need to have them around. And also trying to manage our triggers and resultant emotions that are arising out of that is really important. So, also like journaling about money, asking yourself these questions, researching, watching perhaps YouTube videos, or also reading on philosophy, perhaps reading texts that can help you compare how people have in the past or philosophers see truth, like Kant, Voltaire. Anyone who you like or find interesting, you can go with them. So what do you think love is? How do you define interdependent love versus codependent love? Is love respect, responsibility, not abusive? These are common basic things. Trust, care, honesty. All these things may be fundamental to your relationship. So realizing how do you want to be treated, how do you expect others to treat you in advance, what do you think being responsible is at work, targeting different areas in your life such as targeting finances, health, relationships, the most intimate relationships to acquaintances, to people whom you see regularly as friends but they're not really, you know, like that close to you. We may want to be fair and transparent with everyone, but there may be different levels of sharing. There may be different levels of interaction. So journaling about your identity, who you are. So for instance, I am an American expat who has lived across Asia and America. So that has, it really helps me align with a lot of people, because the more you travel, the more you can get along with a lot of people, and that is great, I love that. But at the same time, it may be difficult to feel like a sense of identity and belonging to a particular place or people, because we just adapt so fast. The more we move around, the quicker we adapt, and we may not realize that with certain people we're behaving a certain way, and like 2 minutes later we're with a different group of people, we're behaving a certain way, and that may confuse us internally. So it's really important to be grounded in who you are, to not just be swayed. And it's great to get along and be flexible and be able to interact successfully with a lot of people. Realizing when, where, how you want to do that on your own terms is important. So just writing out these things really helps, because you can see it in front of you and you can sort of debate with yourself on a piece of paper. Go back and forth, ask like what are the risks, what are the benefits, what are alternatives in this given situation. So before those situations come up, you can sort of have an idea of how you may want to proceed. So in your career, in your spirituality, like you may want to cut out toxic people. In your career, you may want to do certain things, certain goals, how you want to achieve them, how you want to organize your life. These are just questions I'm throwing out there that I've been doing, working on recently. How do you think your past has shaped you? What lessons have you learned? How has your trauma, neglect, etc. affected you in the way you behave, in the way you act, in the way you carry yourself? And if you would like to make alterations, changes, things you've noticed that you want to work on, all these things can really help us grow personally, transform, and get there. So along with affirmations, to explore the world, we have to sort of form conclusions, or at least question things and question the status quo we are in, to be able to achieve bigger and better changes throughout our lives, to keep growing, keep expanding, keep transforming.